Well, this is going to be, the subject is the timeline of the two or three weeks following Father's Day. This calendar is June, and using the very excellent autopsy report as a guide, I have blocked off or marked what happened at what day during as far as the scientific aspect. Now, over here, that's Father's Day. That's in pink, anyway. And then in blue is the start of decomposition, and it goes on for the actual time frame is 2 weeks, but it is far more likely, according to that report, much shorter than 2 weeks. It could be anywhere from 10 days to 14 days. They used, as far as a timeline, they found a city in Mississippi that has almost the identical temperatures in June as does Orlando. And they had a murder there, and they had body of a 12-year-old. Of course, now our victim is much smaller, much younger, and the decomposition would be even faster. So with that information, I am thinking that decomposition was completed at somewhere between 10 and 11 days. Now the blue, this blue line I have up here, is decomposition is going on. Then I have green bar here, and it says the murder plus the body is in the car trunk. And it we have a record on that the fibers in the car trunk were saturated with or exposed to gases of decomposition, gases, for 2.6 days. And so that would put us ending right about there. Now you can obviously see what's a problem here. Here we have the shovel, the 18th, and I feel pretty good about that date, that did occur then. But it really doesn't make much sense that Casey would have gotten the shovel and then put and kept little Caylee's remains in the car trunk. But anyway, the green is in the car trunk. And she's not exposed to animals, supposedly, at this time. Now, we get into this orange part, which is the possibility of animal activity. They will only be active during decomposition. Once it's a skeleton, it ceases. There has to be tissue of some sort on there for them to be active. So we have this. We have, looks like about 8-10 days where there's animal activity. At the completion of the animal activity, or completion of decomposition, where there is no more soft fiber on or soft tissue on the skeleton, that it's in a state of being skeletonized, and the animal activity stopped, and what begins is roots start penetrating or grabbing onto the in and around the skeleton. So that goes on, starts, the roots start here and go on. I'm seeing this backwards, excuse, and right in here and on into July. So you can see by this that we can start seeing a window of what could have the time needed for the formation of gas in the car trunk would have to be 2.5 days. And this really, everything starts to start pointing back to Father's Day. As far as I've got it set for the death occurring on the 16th, but it really looks like the 15th. What a terrible thing, Father's Day. That makes it quite memorable. So anyway, I think that the remains were in the trunk from the end of Father's Day on for the next 2.5 days. That would be the same day that the shovel was asked for. And that makes sense, you know. And this would make sense for the remains to be gone, tossed in that wooded area that early. And that's about right. That makes things tie in, you know, somewhere between the 18th and the 19th, the body was disposed of and rebagged, actually, an additional bag put on it, I guess. I don't see her or anybody putting, I see them maybe double bagging, but the triple bagging, I think it would occur here. Anyway, so there we have, the body is exposed to animal activity from that point on. I'm not used to reading autopsy reports, but I thought that I am just amazed at what they came up with, you know, the FBI and law enforcement and the work that they did, the forensics. If you could describe it a work of art, I think you wouldn't be far off. I'm not sure we've got all the pages yet. I think that probably the prosecution is holding back till the last minute their big bang, you know, the fingerprints on the duct tape, all of Caylee, or Casey, and, you know, these fingerprints put on the duct tape, both the inside and the outside. I think they'll have quite a bit. And some of these other things that makes it just a real done deal. I think they're just going to wait and for them to get any kind of a plea. Casey would have to tell all before any plea deal could be made. And I do feel more and more that this tremendous effort on the part of Cindy and George is due to trying to make Casey feel that she has a chance to beat this. And that's the only reason that she would not plea for her own life, is because her parents don't want her to tell what's, you know, the family secrets, which we know quite a bit of them. And part of this thing that is missing is a something about the DNA. So we shall see. Anyway, let's see if this works.